this video, we will guide you through the initial setup of your Hielscher Sonicator UP400ST. The UP400ST Sonicator comes in a robust transport case. Please place the case on a table with the label facing upward. The case latches open upwards. Inside the case, you will find the Sonicator itself, a stand, various accessories and cables, tools, and the user manuals. The contents may vary depending on your specific order. To begin, please remove the user manuals from the case. For your safety and the smooth operation of the device, carefully read the manuals and, in particular, the safety instructions before first use. A digital copy of the manuals is also available as a PDF on the supplied SD card. Next, take out the fully assembled stand. If present, remove the protective wrapping from the stand rod. If you wish to mount or unmount the stand rod, you can do so at the base of the stand plate. The rod is secured to prevent rotation. Adjust the feet of the stand if necessary to ensure stability, particularly on uneven surfaces. The UP400ST ultrasonic device is available in two voltage variants, 110 volts and 230 volts. We supply the device with a plug suitable for your region. You may replace the power cable with one that has a different plug. However, you must ensure that the mains voltage matches the voltage specified on your UP400ST Sonicator. Please check that the SD card is inserted into the device. With the SD card in place, an Excel-compatible protocol of all relevant sonication parameters will be automatically recorded in real time to the SD card for your documentation. The included temperature sensor connects to the device with an extension cable. This sensor allows you to monitor the liquid temperature on the display and record it on the SD card. You can also set temperature limits at which sonication will automatically pause or stop, which is particularly useful for temperature-sensitive materials. Sonotrodes with various diameters and lengths are available for the UP400ST Sonicator. If you have questions about the best sonotrode for your application, please contact us. Typically, we pre-install a sonotrode on the device prior to shipment, so you can start sonication without additional setup steps. Next, we will show you how to remove and install a sonotrode. For sonotrode replacement, you will need two 17mm open-end spanner wrenches and a wrench extension. We recommend wearing non-slip gloves. Before removing or installing a sonotrode, switch off the device and disconnect it from the power source. This will ensure the device cannot be accidentally activated during these steps. Place the device on a stable, even surface, as shown here. To detach the sonotrode, rotate it counterclockwise. Place the first 17mm wrench on the hex spanner flats on the device, allowing the end of the wrench to rest on the table. Attach the second 17mm wrench with the extension to the sonotrode's hex spanner flats, turning counterclockwise to loosen. For sonotrodes with thin tips, take care not to press the tip against the table, as this could cause bending or damage. The torque is approximately 30 Newton meter or 22 foot-pounds. Before installing a new sonotrode, ensure that both the external thread on the sonotrode and the internal thread on the device are clean, dry, and undamaged. Screw the sonotrode's thread into the device's thread, ensuring proper alignment. The sonotrode should rotate smoothly with minimal effort. If a thread is damaged, do not proceed with installation. Contact us to resolve any issues with your device. To securely fasten the sonotrode to the device, rotate it clockwise. Position the first 17mm wrench on the device's hex spanner flats, with the end resting on the table. Use the second 17mm wrench with the extension to tighten the sonotrode clockwise. Again, ensure that tips of thin sonotrodes do not contact the table, as this may cause bending or damage. The torque is approximately 30 Newton meter or 22 foot-pounds. Attach and secure the device to the stand rod. The immersion depth of the sonotrode should be adjusted so that the sonotrode tip is at least 10 millimeters below the liquid surface and at least 10 millimeters above the bottom of the container. If you have purchased a flow cell, such as the FC22K, please place the cell lid and one O-ring over the threaded connection before installing the Sonotrode. Once the Sonotrode is tightly mounted, place the second O-ring into the designated groove in the flow cell. Insert the Sonotrode into the flow cell and close it. Ensure the O-rings are correctly seated to avoid damage. When using the flow cell, the medium should typically be introduced from the bottom inlet and exit from the topside outlet. The cooling jacket can be supplied with cooling water from either side inlet. Connect the device to the power source, making sure the device variant matches your network voltage to avoid damage. Before turning on the device, ensure that you wear appropriate protective gear, such as gloves, safety glasses, a lab coat, and hearing protection, depending on the material to be sonicated. The UP400ST ultrasonic processor includes numerous innovative features, from cycle mode and amplitude control to remote control via your browser. These functions are described in the user manuals. By familiarizing yourself with these features, you can establish a solid foundation for successful sonication processes and achieve optimal results. At Hielscher Ultrasonics, we are committed to ensuring you can operate your ultrasonic device effectively to achieve the best possible sonication results. Our technical team is ready to assist you in every way. Please contact us with any questions or issues. We would also be happy to explain the device functions in a detailed video conference. Thank you for your attention. We hope this video has been helpful. For more information on the UP400ST ultrasonic device and its various applications, please visit our website at www.hielscher.com/UP400ST.